My name's Trevor Gilligan. I mix front of house sound for the Australian Pink Floyd. Been doing it for about 2 years now. Thoroughly enjoying it. It's a great gig to do. Well, the sound originates from the instrument or the amplifier, you know, made by the musicians. And we mic it up with the AKG set of microphones that we've got. Sonically, they're very good. Rejection for feedback is excellent. And they just have a very natural, open sound, which is exactly what we want as an engineer, you know. So you can have a lot of open mics, so you don't have to keep muting everything and worrying if that one's picking that the guitar's up or whatever. Vocal mics, I'd never used them before. I do like the crisp top end they've got, but it's not too excessive. Good proximity effect, which means you can pull away from them and you don't lose too much bottom end, it just naturally rolls. When we do like arenas that have a lot of sort of 3 and 6K going around, you can keep good control of them. This is a D7 mic that I'm speaking into, and this is the same mic as we use for all the vocals. I did a one-off show filling in for a good friend of mine, Colin Norfield, who mixes David Gilmour. Went to Rocklaw in Poland, and David Gilmour uses these same microphones, and again with his really good voice that he's got, the microphone performed beautifully and got that David Gilmour sound, you know, without having to do too much to it, because I can run these quite flat, just a bit of roll off, and it's like I say, it just reproduces the vocals very, very well. So the drum kit. We start with the overheads, which are 414s, and on the, if we come around here, we've got one on the, picks the two ride cymbals up for that nice Floyd, you know, tinkly top end. The kick drum mic, which is again phenomenal, is a D12 VR. Thanks, Matt, which I'd never used before, but I'll definitely be using that again, because again, you put it in and it just sounds wicked, powerful, never bottoms out, even when the drummer goes L for leather on the beat, you know. On the toms, we use C518s, which is a little gooseneck condenser mic. Really crisp sound, but controllable. I've started using a lot of the tom sounds without any gates at all, which is working out really good. Because obviously, when you introduce a gate, any gate, it can take the edge off stuff. And they're just a pleasure to use. On the snare top, we use a D40, which is proving really good. Quite punchy mic. It's got a good bottom end in it. On Steve's setup, we're using the AKG 451Bs, which are good. You know, nice, clean, open guitar sound. On Steve's 4B12 cabinets, we're using the 214s, which again have a nice big diaphragm type sound. Our keyboard player, Jason, does a thank you sort of part of the show, talks to the audience. So he gets the special silver D7. I'm sure he enjoys that, and it does sparkle a bit in the lights. On the saxophones, we use the D40. It's like we do on the snare drum. It's proven really good for the saxophones, as in you can, at low blowing level, you can get a lot of output, again, with no feedback. So when we do songs like Us and Them, you can get the perfect original sax sound in an arena, which can be difficult, but with these mics, perfect. So all in all, when you've got a really great band, like I've got to mix, you've got good microphones, good PA system, good guys working everything, you end up with a great gig, which is what we're getting at the moment. So I couldn't be happier.